Team M, and this is our project 5.4. I'm Sam Bublik.
I'm Sam Harris.
I'm Hitam.
Lorenzo Secchi.
And we hope you enjoy our presentation.
Our product is designed for the characters in the movie, and we through the research we found out Baku is a kind of potential characters in the movie, so we want to design a new weapon for him. And we try to combine what we research for the African culture and the materials with what they used in the movie. We want to build a powerful weapon for him.
So we gathered data by conducting primary and secondary research for this project. For our primary research, we interviewed someone that gave us good insight on the movie. He was also a super fan. And then for our secondary research, we gathered a list of 25 pictures and other things, such as this club and the old costume that they used in actual film to help us inspire for our prototype. From this, we did a usability test in which we tested two super fans for the movie and then two casual fans, so we can get a good consensus of what balance was going forward. And then we also looked at all the African art that we found in the movie to help us gather our prototype.
Going into designing this weapon, we knew that M'Baku was an incredibly popular character. We decided that he needed a bigger role in the sequel, move him from a just kind of a secondary character to a main character. We also worked to build a storyboard in which this weapon would be naturally like given to him. It didn't seem out of place in the film. It'd have something to do with him being rewarded for his service in the first movie. We also wanted to make sure that the weapon itself wasn't too far-fetched and that it seemed like it fit in. We used our usability tests to see if we had done this correctly. It was one of the questions we asked people, is if it felt natural, to which they normally said it did. There was one person that kind of felt out of place. We also wanted to make it inspired with the Jabari tribe, which is M'Baku's like actual tribe that he runs. We also wanted to implement the gorilla god Hanuman, who the Jabari worship, into the design. We used inspiration from the comics as well. M'Baku's like comic counterpart, his name is Manape, and he wears the skull of a gorilla that he killed. That's actually how he got his powers, was by eating its heart. We used the purple aura from his weapon as well in our initial concept. With our first concept, we decided that we wanted to go with a vibranium gorilla skull club. We quickly worked in the first movie, his club is just an ordinary African war club, but it's made with Jabari sacred wood. It's everything in their like village is made of this. So we decided that the base of the club would be made out of that. The base being their wood and the skull being the vibranium from like T'Challa's tribe also is kind of symbolic of their newfound peace between the two tribes. We wanted to also implement with the vibranium technology something similar to T'Challa's suit in the first movie, where it can build up kinetic energy and then be released. Our first design, it had a meter that showed how much it was building up. We quickly realized that this just kind of felt out of place. We wanted something a little bit more mystical and fun for a movie, so we decided to go with the inspired comic design with the purple aura that would show like the more he hit things, this purple aura would build up and up, and eventually he could release all the energy out of his club. The prototype that we went with, we designed on Adobe Illustrator. We decided to put the club in two scenes from the movie. That would try and, we used this on our usability test to try and see if it felt natural in the movie. We just replaced, like we drew it out and then replaced his original club with these. We also went into a little bit more detail about the club that we gave the people, just talking about the vibranium skull, the fact that it was inspired from Hanuman. We also talked just about the kind of the powers of the club and what made it special.
Our technical strategy for our new design was to make sure that the weapon would be feasible in the new Black Panther movie. And looking at that, the available resources available to our business strategy, we wanted to reinvent M'Baku as more of a heroic figure in the second movie. We think this would appeal to his current cult following, along with bring a new following along with it. We wanted to also stay true to his character. A lot of people liked his sense of humor, and we wanted to make sure to keep that in the second movie. We wanted to unveil his new weapon as early as possible by featuring it in one of the trailers and showing it in action. This would increase popularity for the movie and make it trending, maybe possibly on things such as social media, Twitter, and on other chat forums. We also wanted to start producing toys with like companies like Mattel, Fisher-Price to help promote the new weapon, and also have other kind of promotional materials like Halloween costumes and things like that.